Okay. I guess we go around and see what we can do with this monitor. First, yeah. You're not going through there.
I don't think this is going to fit.
Hmm.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Will not fit. Okay, let's go somewhere else and try something. I think that's Spock? Yeah. No. Huh.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Which door do we come out of? This one? Display monitor on knees. Stop ambling around.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Not necessary. Okay, let's go back. So annoying just getting around this place. If we can lower these force fields, then the fun will really begin. Then we can really look at all this stuff. But we can't interact with it. We can't get a readout with our tricorders with those fields up. So, let's go this one. Doop 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 doop. Oh, we just came from here. Let's go through here then. This machine is used for combining parts with other parts, and we can't even try to do it. Oh, wait. This is the one. Oh, crap. We're going in circles here. We'll try the far one. We'll try this one.
Spock raises an eyebrow.
Did we ever? I don't know if we spoke in this place before.
Machines. Machines everywhere, not a body to fix.
Not exactly festive around here, is it?
I was examining that computer, Captain. Very interesting. The computer has an exceedingly large display screen. There are several conclusions.
What conclusions, Spock?
One, the individuals for whom this equipment was built have substandard vision.
Hmm.
Two, the users have quite long arms or manipulative extremities and have to work a considerable distance away from the console and screen. Three, the large screen and lack of anything else in the room could mean it was expected that more than one individual would be viewing the display.
Right.
Captain, I do not have the equipment necessary to activate the screen.
I tried this stuff, didn't I?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Let me just try one more thing.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Alright, well, you actually have to operate it with this, but we have to bring down the force field first. Wait, what is that control? That's outside.
The light is provided by the surface of the room absorbing energy, then releasing it as light.
The light?
This seems pointless.
This looks like a control of some kind.
The light is provided. The light is provided.
Okay, the light is provided. All right, let's go through here. try the monitor on this thing.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Not necessary. Let's go through here. Ah, our patient has gotten up and wandered off.
Spock, can you apply this to that machine?
Captain, this part will not interfere.
Spock, can you apply this to that machine?
Captain, this part will not...
It probably goes somewhere.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
I just don't know where. That doesn't work.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think...
This device appears to be of the...
Some tough puzzles, huh? So we came through there. Yep, okay. So, yeah, I'm not sure. Obviously, I don't know what to do at this point. We will go through the far door in the next room. To the left. I'm not sure what's there. I do not have this layout memorized. End. Yeah. Back to where we started. Damn.
Captain, I doubt that your hand phaser will be able to penetrate that force field.
So do I.
Captain, I doubt that you're happy. It will be difficult to determine the effect of this item on the computer if I am unable to physically touch the machine. The energy field is blocking any tricorder readings of the machinery inside.
A bin containing very small discs.
Ooh, can we get stuff out of there?
A bin containing small badges.
Badges and discs.
There are still several batteries in the bin, Captain.
the discs or batteries.
Captain, the tricorder readings indicate there are small devices in that container. The devices are related in some way to energy fields. It would take a closer examination to be certain.
Okay. Oh, I obviously missed this.
Something in here that looks like a tiddlywink spot. You don't think this is really some sort of game table?
Tiddlywink.
The bin contains small plastic discs, Captain. The plastic is essentially inert in this form. However, if placed under pressure, it will become a superconductor capable of storing significant energy compared to its size.
Wow.
It will break down over time. That is why it is commonly stored in this state.
I'm assuming these go into that press on the table.
That device would provide the necessary activation pressure.
Probably should hang on to a few, don't you think?
A logical choice.
Cool. Okay, so we've got some. Is it this?
A small disc of plastic.
That does not look like a plastic. I mean, disc. It kind of looks like a Nintendo controller.
Here's something, Spock. What is it?
Walk away.
Captain, these items appear to be configured to produce a small energy field of some sort. They do not appear to be powered at this time.
Are these the things that go into the machine on the table over there?
That would seem to be logical placement, Captain.
This room shares the basic construction design of...
Shut up.
A small gray badge.
Looks like a notebook.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Sure about that?
Nothing unusual about...
Okay. I figured just about everything here is... unusual. So we're gonna put these together to do what? Make a badge?
An electric... Batteries have been placed into the device.
A battery charged badge. I thought I selected this one.
The badges have been placed into the hopper, Captain.
Hopper. I don't know why they call it a hopper. Use machine?
Since we know this is a high-pressure device, it would be logical to either use it or leave it alone.
I choose use it.
What is that smell?
There is a chemical change due to the pressure. That is simply a small amount of outgassing by the plastic, Doctor. Captain, the badges and batteries are now joined.
Do we have them? Oh, cool.
A small gray badge thickened by the presence of a plastic disc pressed into its structure.
Analyze, Mr. Spock.
Nothing unusual about that object.
Oh god, that is not the correct answer, Mr. Spock. What do we do with these now?
Since we know this is a high pressure...
I don't think it's alive, Jim. Anything else?
Good question. What will we do with this now?
Captain, these badges are already assembled.
Yeah. Who knows what stench it would make if you put that in again.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. Spock, see what you can do with that computer.
Captain, there is no way to interface this part with the computer.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Alright, well, the only thing I can think is to go to another room and try to use this thing on everything. Like this. Ooh! What are we doing?
The badges change color.
I believe the units are now fully operational.
Hopefully these badges will help us with some of these force fields. We should each keep one of them with us while we're here.
Righto! Can we disable the force field now? It changed color.
A small, thick card. It has an indicator showing that it has been charged recently.
Cool.
Nothing unusual about.
I had a feeling you'd say that. Well, now what do we do with it?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Yeah.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Okay, not necessary.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Captain Kirk realizes that for all of his skills, he's not the man for this job.
Haha. I meant to hit.
No, I don't think that's...
Spockaroo.
I do not see the logic in that action.
Not the wall. That. This thing came down. Nice. Why did it come down? Just because we have the badge? Randomly? Check it out.
A large computer and display screen.
Mm-hmm.
A large computer.
Okay, analyze Mr. Spock.
This is a computer control panel, Captain. It appears to have some control over other parts of the compound.
Awesome. Play with it. It looks fun.
This console is non-operational, Captain. Mm. However, I do believe the repair would be a simple matter given the right materials. There are essentially no controls or displays available at this time.
Oh, could it be one of the other goodies we have with us? Maybe this cube thingy? Gonna walk all over the place. Cool.
This modification is not all that is necessary to gain access to the computer. It still requires a display unit.
Alright, we have that. Before I try that, though, I'm just curious to try these other things.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Alright, the monitor thingy.
Captain, this modification has completed the repairs of this unit. I should be able to deactivate a force field somewhere in this complex.
Just one?
Spock is too intent on studying things to get involved in a conversation right now.
Machines. Machines everywhere, and not a body to fix.
Not exactly festive around here, is it?
I can shut down the force field protecting the generator. Do you wish me to do so?
No, let's look around a bit more first.
The generator.
Yes, we'll finally be able to take a better look at it. No, let's look around. Yes, we'll...
Captain, my attempt to turn off the force field has triggered some sort of computer activity. It is awaiting confirmation to bring a display up on the screen. Shall I confirm?
I don't know if that's a good idea. Let's wait. By all means, Spock. Curiosity may kill cats, but I'm hoping humans will fare a little better.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's a good idea. By all means, Spock.
That's comforting, Jim.
That one. Oh. Great. A logic puzzle. Oh, we're supposed to determine what the missing shape is. So, I got some trapezoid. Basically, square house, diamond house, diamond, triangle, diamond, diamond. Any kind of order that I can see. Five sides. Six sides, right? Twelve? Five. 14? 12, 14. Well, if we got 12, 14, maybe this is another 2 later? 12, well, I can't make 13, I don't have that. It's one side. 2, 4, 5. This is definitely 12. Yeah, we gotta click on one of these here.
It seems that we have chosen incorrectly, Captain.
What's the matter, Jim? Been that long since childhood? We used to play this kind of game all the time.
No, Bones, it hasn't been that long. I just haven't seen a puzzle quite like this one.
I must confess a lack of familiarity with this particular scheme. Vulcan puzzles are more abstract. There were 4 available shapes that might solve the puzzle.
One of the shapes should make all 3 lines equal in some way.
That would seem logical, Captain.
Well, that's what I was trying to do. Well, maybe vertically, not horizontally. Can we try again?
Captain, there is another display waiting to be activated. Shall I continue?
No, that last puzzle gave me a headache. Absolutely. I'm sure we'll do better this time.
Do we have to, Jim? I hate tests.
Activating.
You can stand there and do nothing, Bones. Like usual. Alright. We got 5, 8, 9 here. We got 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Unless these count for 0, it should be. So unless we're talking this way, which is 11. 12, 13, 14. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 9, 10. Okay, we got 10 and 10. So we got 4. five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
It appears we have chosen correctly, Captain. The controls indicate that the force field has been dropped.
We have to do this crap every time. I don't even remember where that was. I think it might be one of these doors. Oh, we can go right through. I didn't even... Okay, cool.